Hello there guys, glad to see you watching another video of mine. And today, we lost 3-0. I mean, I'm laughing because instead of laughing, you know, you either laugh or cry. But let's get straight into it. Messi, he had a field day today. He contributed to all the goals. And Courtois. He got made twice. I mean, and almost gave away a third. But I've been saying for a long time that he's no longer a world-class keeper. Ever since he had that knee injury, it seems like every shot, every other shot, it gets past him. He doesn't make saves anymore. And and the first goal came. Well, the first two goals came from the left side where Alonso was at. And what I've been saying is, I think now Alonso is a liability. I think now, since we don't have really any much competition left to play in, like we're out of the Champions League, we're not going to win a title. Now I think it's the time to play Palmieri. So, you know, give Alonso a break, I guess, because again today, other than the free kick when he hit the bar, he did nothing but give away goals. I was kind of 25%. I was 25% confident that we would go through and beat Barcelona, but Barcelona was always the favorite, so I'm not really shocked that we're not going through. But the breakdown of tactics, when we were off the ball, we did the typical 5-4-1 shape that we do, but we pressed higher. We looked positive, at least somewhat, going forward. We just couldn't play the final pass, the final ball. Barcelona, I think they noticed what I've been noticing, is that our defensive weakness is on the side where Alonso is, at the left side. Because the first two goals came there, and they seemed to put all their focus on that right, their left side, their right-hand side. And I was surprised that Dembele didn't play in the first game, because what he did this game, he stretched us out more. The first game, we were allowed to crowd and frustrate Barcelona because they didn't have enough width. But when you add Dembele out there on the wide side, he can beat players with his pace, with his skill on the ball, and obviously, he's a pretty good finisher as well. I wasn't expecting Iniesta to play or at least start, because he's had a hamstring injury. But he came back. He didn't play the full game, but he played 60 minutes, which is still pretty good. You know, coming off an injury, he was supposed to be out for another week for, but he came back early for it. So that's all. I'm not gonna make any excuses. Conte subbed Hazard off again for Pedro. He made subs a bit late again, but I mean, it's the same old. You know, I'm tired of talking about what he should have did, what he shouldn't have done. Barcelona was clearly the better team, but it makes you think. First leg, you know, William puts the ball in, doesn't hit the bar twice before putting that first goal in. If he scores two goals, if he gets a hat trick, the whole fixture changes. But I really want to see Barca versus Manchester City. I think that's a very good, that'll be a nice, interesting leg to see. Two tacticians. I'm neutral now, so I don't care who wins now. I think it's either Bayern and City who's going to win the Champions League. I've always kind of felt that way. But, you know, as a Chelsea fan, I have a little Chelsea bias, man. I always think we're going to win. No matter what, win or lose, this badge right here, I die by the badge. You know, this wasn't our day today. It happens. It was a penalty call. When it happened, I was screaming, that's a penalty, but the replay showed that it really wasn't a penalty. I'm not going to complain about the referee, because at the end of the day, we didn't play well enough. We were second best the entire game. And, I don't know. What do you guys think?